So first we switch off the grids and go to limits, and by specify lower left corner, which is 0, 0, enter, then specify upper right corner 297, 210, then zoom, Z, enter, take the option all, enter. Now we need to write the sheet size. So to do that, command is line. So we'll keep the ortho on. So that means we can draw a horizontal line. Just specify first point. You just click on the first corner of any corner of the point and then drag the mouse and then click on the second next point. Since it is ortho mode is on, so it will draw a horizontal line. And then from this point, again, you click on the second first button of the mouse to get the vertical line. Once you get this, and now you just press enter key. Now go to offset. Now we have to set the offset distance. Since we want to draw an A4 size sheet, which is 297. So offset 297 in the horizontal direction. So you select the vertical line. Specify, select object to offset, you select this line and offset to the left side, you take the cursor to the left side and click on the first button of the mouse. Again, you just press enter key. Now, since the previous command is offset, you just press offset again and type 210, enter, then select object to offset, select the horizontal line and offset to the top side. You just take the cursor on the top side and then click on the first button of the mouse and then press enter key. Then say zoom, Z, enter, take the extends option, you type E. So we're going to get this, then zoom 0.7x, then go to fillet. So by default the radius is 0, so you just take this vertical line and click inside of this horizontal line. So you're going to get the sharp corner, again fillet. Select this vertical line and this horizontal line. Again, you select fillet, select this vertical line and this horizontal line. So now we have the rectangle of 297 by 210. Now you just go to zoom extends and zoom 0.7x. Now we will take, now we will go to write the problem. So to write the problem here, the point capital P is 45 mm above HP, 60 mm behind VP and 30 mm from RPP. Draw the three principal views of the point and also state the quadrant in which it lies. So first go to dtext and select the position by clicking on the first button of the mouse. That will going to be the start point. Specify text height as 4, enter. Specify rotation angle as 0. So this is the problem number 3. You just take a point capital P is 45 mm above HP, comma 60 mm behind VP, and 30 mm from RPP. Draw the three principal views of the point also state the quadrant in which it lies. So this is the problem, and then to cancel this you just press enter key. It will go to the next line, and again you just give a null return so that it will go into cancel the command. Now we need to start the drawing. So to do that, first we need to adjust the line thickness. So go to layer, select command is layer, type LA and enter. So here in the layer dialog box, you just come down to line weight. The line weight by default is 0. I mean by default layer having some assumable thickness. Now we go for 0.05 mm and you just click on OK and then say close. Now we need to draw a horizontal line. So within this rectangle, you just go to line command, draw a line, select from specify first point, you select some orbital point on the screen and draw a horizontal line, and then select, pick the second point here, then enter key. Similarly, you just take the line command again, draw a vertical line. Now it will still be here because it is in the second quadrant. So here, zoom window, bring it near to the screen, then go to date text, and here take the specify start point of text. You click here by clicking on the first button of the mouse, specify height 4, enter, specify rotation angle is 0, and you type VP, put the caps lock on VP, and then you write HP in bracket because both are overlapping with each other, and here RPP, then go to move, push the caps lock ortho off, move, select some arbitrary point and drag it near to the origin. Similarly, HP also, you drag it and keep it here, and then RPP, bring it here. Now we need to draw the parallel line of from to this vertical line by a distance of 30. So go to offset. To draw a parallel entity, we have to go for offset. Specify offset distance, since he has given 30 mm, so you type 30. So first set the distance, and now select object to offset, select this vertical line and offset to the left side. Then again, he says 45 mm above HP, so go to offset and set the distance as 45, and take this horizontal line and offset by 45 mm to the top side. Similarly, offset, select this distance, again take the distance as 60 behind VP, so you select this line and offset to the top side. Then go to trim, trim select, so select objects to trim cutting edges, you select this line and also this line, these two are the cutting edges, and enter, then select object to trim this line, this line, and this line, then trim, select this line and trim it this side. So now we have the points. So and then I want to draw a 45 degree line, so go to line, take the intersection point of these two, and then at the rate you take 100 mm less than 45, because now it is in the counterclockwise direction. And now from the top view, so this point is the top view line. So draw a line INT of this. From here, draw a perpendicular to this horizontal line. So perpendicular to this. Then go to fillet, select between these two, and select between these two. So once you do that, then go to zoom previous, then zoom window, then go to break, select this, break till here, then break till here, then break till here, then break till here, then break from here till here. Then go to donut, 0, and the outer diameter is 2, and take intersection point of this, and then intersection point of this, and then intersection point of this. Then go to dim, DDIM. Now we're going to set the dimensioning variables. So go to modify, then go to primary units, decimal, linear dimension, you keep it 0, angular dimension is already 0. Then go to text, so take text height as 3, and then align with the dimension line. We can change the dimension text whatever way you want. Then go to vertical, centered, keep it above. Then offset from the dimension line, you take it 2, that is the text placement of this 2. Then symbols and arrows, take the arrow size as 3. Then here, come down to lines, offset from the origin. So this line from here, take the dimension as 2 mm and say OK. And then now we'll take up dim horizontal, take center of this, to intersection point of this. And so here this dimension will be 30. then dim vertical, take center of this and intersection of this line, and keep the dimension text here, which is 45. Again take vertical, take center of this and take intersection point of this. So this dimension is 60. Then dim angular, select this line and this line, and you keep it 45 degrees. So now we'll go for D text, put the caps lock on. So here the text height is 4, write X and this is Y, and you take X1 and this is Y1, and then now we need to go for now you adjust this, move, place it wherever you want, like appropriately. Then we go for leader, take the nearest point on this line and put the caps lock on or ortho on, and drag it and place it here. So here, so to do that, I will go for dim, go to modify, go to arrow and take this arrow size as 4, say OK and close it. Then go to leader, take nearest point on this and draw a ortho mode on and drag it, annotation, options, and select none. Similarly, leader, nearest point on this and select this. Take annotation is the default, enter, options is also enter, and take the none option here, type N. Similarly, leader, nearest point of this, and drag this and put the second point. You select by clicking on the first button of the mouse, annotation, you just give a null return, options also none return, and give none, select none option. So go to explode this, and also explode this. Then go to erase this line, and erase this line. Then click on XY and X1 Y1 line, and go to change properties, and come down to line weight, and make it 0.13, and then say close. So this is how you will be able to create the draw the sketch by using the AutoCAD software.